I'll be showing you how to troubleshoot microwave. With this troubleshooting, you'll be able to solve any problem in it. Remove the cabinet nuts by losing this. Lose this. This. Put on a multimeter. I'll put it on continuity test. Yeah. If you hit read, that means the fuse has not blown. The power fuse is not blown. So the fuse is not blown. That has been ruled out now. So the next one you should check is the thermal fuse again. Sometimes you may need to lose the thermal fuse and test it. But you can still test it with it by this. You can get a reading from these two terminals. The thermal fuse is okay too. Then we'll go down to the switch. This is this. The door switches. These are the two terminals to the door switches. Yeah. If you test this door for continuity now, it should not read until you close it. Now let's test now. It's not reading, huh? Let's close the door now. That means the switch is okay. That's first switch. Then the second switch too. We do the same thing for it. See it here? This upper one. Put it like this. And here, the upper one here. You can hear the noise. So if you open it now, do not make any noise again. So the switch is okay. Then if your own microwave has a relay here, if you have a relay here, you test the relay with continuity too. But this one is not relay. So it's not relay. But if you have a relay here, have it tested for continuity. It tests. If it's okay, that means your transformer will be producing 110 volts. If it's not okay, you have two options. Either this connector is not making enough contact, or the relay is bad. But this one, you don't have the relay here. So in case you are not, your microwave is not heating up, you can just smack it. When you power it on, then you plug the microwave, then you knock here. If there's a partial contact, you see the thing will hot, or the magnetron will start making booming noise. That means the contact with the relay is not okay. And the next thing you need to check is your transformer. The transformer is supposed to bring out 120 volts at this primary winding in a very good case. So bring your multimeter here, take it to 200 volt AC. 200 volt AC. Then you strip this one here. You strip it up. Strip it up here. Then make sure you're not using this type. Use this. Then plug your microwave. Plug it to socket and power it on. Once it is powered on, make sure you are using this kind type of probe. Then you should get your connection from here to this. Make sure your, before you touch this thing, make sure your microwave is off first. Make sure it's off and you have discharged your capacitor. Make sure your microwave is unplugged from the socket and discharge your capacitor. Discharge by doing this, connecting the two here together. That means your capacitor has been discharged this way. Then strip this on properly. Strip this. Then, now, multimeter now. You read 120 volts, not less than 120 volts. So, if you read anything less than 120 volts, that means your transformer is not working. It's not working well or has a fault. Two things is that this relay that's here is not giving the transformer a high voltage, or the fuse here, or this fuse is blown. This fuse is connected to the capacitor. If this fuse is blown, though not all microwave has this fuse, if this fuse is blown, you will not have 120 volts here. Therefore, you check this fuse and this relay. They are the two culprits when you have less than 120 volts from the primary winding. Open this fuse. Open it this way. Open it this way and check. And check the connection. If they are okay, then you are fine. This one was not okay, so I just repair it. If this fuse is bad, you just go and buy another fuse. You find alternative fuse, you check the name here, you remove this plastic. You see this fuse, just 5 milliampere, 5 kilovolt fuse. The fuse is here, is the one that powers that will support your transformer to give you 120 volts. Then, if that's not the problem, you go and test this diode, this average diode. This diode, if you want to test it, you connect your multimeter. So multimeter has a multimeter, put it at 2000 ohms. I don't have 2000 ohms here. You need 2000 ohms to test this your multimeter. To test this your average diode, because it is the one that give the transformer support to produce the high voltage and also stop the louder noise from the magnetron. So you test it if it's working well. Now to test it now, you need to remove it. Check my second video, you see how to test high voltage diode. You remove it. If you have 2000 ohms on your multimeter, put your put one of the alligator connector on one, and the other one on the other side here. Then you should read. Look at what you want. You should be reading I. See. Then when you put it in a reverse case, then you should read something around 30 or 20 or 40. Even on that. So check my second video, you see how to test I of digital out. You test your multimeter, your capacitor to the ground. You put it here and connect it to the ground like this. Check it to the ground. So that you can be sure that the capacitor is not short circuit. You do for the second time the same thing to be sure that it's capacitor is not short circuit or open circuit. Then the next thing to test here after this and this is the magnetron. In a real sense, you need to remove this magnetron. There's only one knot that holds it. Use the one knot here, and no, sorry, three knots and these two knots here. Then remove the terminal here. This magnetron should give you 0.03 ohm when you read it. Anything from that, 2 to 3 ohms. Anything aside that, render your magnetron useless. If you don't get that ohms, then your magnetron is bad. If you remove the capacitor, to test capacitor is very simple. When you break it out, you remove the capacitor, you lose this, I think, cable. You remove it, then on your multimeter, you set your multimeter to 20 ohm, 20 mega ohm. Then you put your connector on them like this. It should read continuously to 10 million. This is what you've done. No, what you've done. It should not go, it should not slow, it should not have 10 million or so. So, you, if you did not read in this manner, that means your capacitor is bad. You should be reading continuously to 10 million or plus. Then, if you now test it like this to the ground or to the body and find out it reads, that means your multimeter, your capacitor is short circuit. You test your multimeter, your capacitor to the ground. You put it here and connect it to the ground like this. Check it to the ground. So that you can be sure that the capacitor is not short circuit. You do for the second time the same thing to be sure that it's capacitor is not short circuit or open circuit. And the next thing to test here after this and this is the magnetron. In a real sense, you need to remove this magnetron. There's only one knot that holds it. Use the one knot here and no, sorry, three knots and these two knots here. Then remove the terminal here. This magnetron should give you 0.03 ohm when you read it. Anything from that, 2 to 3 ohms. Anything aside that, render your magnetron useless. If you don't get that ohms, then your magnetron is bad. next thing to test is the magnetron. The magnetron serves as the powerhouse. Sorry, it's just like the main microwave because it's the main heating element in the microwave. So high voltage magnetron. Be careful while you work on this all these components: transformer, capacitor, magnetron. Now to test the magnetron, now make sure you have already unplugged the socket, discharge the capacitor, then you set your multimeter to 200 ohms. 200 ohms. Then you now test. You should have 0.02 or 3 ohms. Anything from that, the magnetron is defect. It's bad. So now let's test. So this means this magnetron is okay. And with this now, you are troubleshoot every component on this. If you're having any issue about the turntable, you go down there, but it's not a common issue. So if your microwave is bad, either it's not coming on or it's not eating, test from the start, from the power fuse. Then you come to these switches, these door switches. They are the common problem. The door switches, the power fuse, the fuse, the secondary fuse from the transformer too. Then the magnetron and the transformer can be bad too. Once you are able to check these five things, or the thermal fuse, you are okay. The microwave is going to work perfectly. Like my page and subscribe to my YouTube for very good video coming up next week. Thank you as you watch.